हेलो हेलो लेट्स कंटिन्यू आवर प्रीवियस क्लास डिस्कशन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दैट द वोल्टेज रेगुलेशन इक्वेशन फॉर द लैगिंग पावर फैक्टर रोल, फॉर द लैगिंग पावर फैक्टर रोल। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जस्ट to share the screen and then we will continue our discussion. So this equation we already derived in the previous class, that is voltage regulation at the lagging power factor. That means E2 minus V2 divided by E2 equal to epsilon R cos theta 2 plus epsilon X sin theta 2. Okay. So similarly, if you drive the for leading power factor, if you drive the equation for the leading power factor, then it becomes maybe right here epsilon R equal to here epsilon R equal to I2 square R2 R2 divided by E2 I2 R. So ohmic loss at rated current divided by rated volt ampere. So epsilon R equal to where epsilon R equal to I2 R I2 equal to I2 R R E2 secondary equivalent resistance. So R E2 divided by E2 equal to I2 R square RE2 I2 square R I2 square R that means multiply I2 R in numerator and denominator. So the numerator part will becomes I2 square R into RE2 RE2 divided by E2 I2 R. Did not E2 I2 R. Is equal to ohmic losses at rated current by rated volt ampere. Ohmic losses at rated current by rated volt ampere. Rated volt ampere. So this is per unit resistance n to per unit resistance. Okay. Similarly, the epsilon x equal to I2 square xe2 divided by e2 I2. That means per unit leakage reactance. Similarly, we can obtain for the leading power factor load. Similarly, for leading power factor load, leading power factor load. Voltage regulation is equal to voltage regulation equal to E2 minus V2 by E2 equal to how much? E2 minus V2 divided by E2 is equal to epsilon r cos theta 2 minus epsilon x sin theta 2 in place of previous equation minus place of plus. So epsilon r, that is per unit equivalent resistance in per unit, that is epsilon r cos theta 2 minus epsilon x sin theta 2 minus epsilon x, that is equivalent leakage reactance in per unit, epsilon x sin theta 2 So this equation you must be always kept in your mind for the lagging and leading power factor. That is epsilon r cos theta 2 plus minus epsilon x sin theta 2 plus sign for lagging power factor and minus sign for leading power factor. Okay. So this equation must be always kept in your mind whenever you are going to solve any numerical problem based on the voltage regulation. Okay. Is it not? So next, we will try to find out the condition for zero voltage regulation. Okay. So next, how we can find out what is the condition for zero voltage regulation? What is the condition for getting the zero voltage regulation? Now we can find out that condition. Condition for zero voltage regulation. Voltage regulation. Means epsilon r cos theta 2 plus epsilon n sin theta 2 equal to 0. Voltage regulation 0, that means what is the voltage the regulation equation? Cos epsilon r cos theta 2 plus epsilon x sin theta 2 equal to 0. Okay. So just try to find out. So voltage regulation equation we have already derived in few minutes earlier. So epsilon r cos theta 2 epsilon r cos theta 2 plus epsilon x sin theta 2 plus epsilon x sin theta 2 equal to 0. So from this equation we can find out here sin theta 2 equal to minus epsilon r divided by epsilon x. So tan theta 2 equal to here minus epsilon r by epsilon x. So tan theta 2 equal to minus epsilon r divided by epsilon x, minus epsilon r epsilon x. So from this equation we can find out the cos theta 2, that is equal to minus cos theta 2 equal to x e 2 by z e 2. Cos theta 2 equal to x e 2 divided by z e 2. Cos theta 2 equal to x e 2 divided by z e 2. That means load power factor is equal to x e 2 divided by z e 2. So at this power factor, load power factor, cos theta 2 equal to x 2 by z 2, the voltage regulation will become 0. Okay. And negative sign of theta 2 is indicate that at leading power factor. So 0 voltage regulation may be obtained from the transformer at leading power factor, that value is equal to x 2 by z 2. Okay. So the negative value of tan theta 2 indicate a leading power factor. The negative sign of tan theta 2 of tan theta to indicate that indicate a leading power factor, okay. So this is the condition for the zero voltage regulation. Next, we just go for maximum voltage regulation. Then what is the condition for the maximum voltage regulation? So how we can find out the condition for the maximum voltage regulation? As you may be know that for maximum and minimum, we just differentiate and get to the zero. Okay. So this voltage regulation equation differentiate with respect to theta 2, that is load power factor angle. And equal to zero. Okay, equal to zero, and the condition derived from this equation. So, condition for maximum voltage regulation. That means differentiate voltage regulation equation with respect to theta 2 and equal to 0. So you already derived the voltage regulation equation in per unit. So just write here. The per unit voltage regulation equation. Differentiate with respect to per unit voltage regulation differentiate with respect to load angle theta 2, okay, and equate to 0. So theta 2, that means differentiate epsilon x epsilon r cos theta 2 epsilon r cos theta 2 plus epsilon x sin theta 2 cos theta 2 plus epsilon x sin theta 2 plus epsilon x sin theta 2 and differentiate with respect to theta 2, this equation So epsilon x sine theta 2 with respect to theta 2. So what is the differentiation of cos theta 2? What is the differentiation of cos theta 2? Equal to minus sin theta 2, and sin theta 2 differentiation is your cos theta 2. So this one we will written as minus epsilon r sin theta 2 minus epsilon r sin theta 2 plus epsilon x cos theta 2 plus epsilon x cos theta 2. Cos theta 2. Equal to 0. Okay. So just find out the value of tan theta 2 from this equation. So tan theta 2 equal to, we can just write xe2 by re2. Tan theta 2 equal to epsilon r xe2 divided by re2. X e2, that means equivalent decay reactance referred to the secondary side. Okay. So X e2 divided by R e2 so tan theta 2 equal to X e2 by R e2. So from here we can write the value of cos theta 2 equal to how much? R into divided by AD2. Okay. So cos theta 2 equal to cos theta 2 is equal to RE2 divided by JD2. RE2 divided by JD2. Cos theta 2 equal to RE2 by ZE2. Theta 2 equal to RE2 by ZE2. So what is the condition for the maximum voltage regulation? Maximum voltage regulation can be obtained at the power factor of RE2 by JD2. That is load power factor equal to cos theta 2 equal to RE2 by JD2. At this power factor, you will get the maximum voltage regulation. So here the theta 2 is positive, so that means the obtained at the lagging power factor load. Lagging power factor load. Next, this is the cos theta 2 value. Now, what is the maximum voltage regulation? This one is the condition for at this load power factor, you will get the maximum. So, what is the value of voltage regulation? So, you just put the cos theta 2 value equal to RE2 by JD2 in voltage regulation equation. That means epsilon R into cos theta 2. In place of cos theta 2, you just write the RE2 by JD2. Okay. And similarly, from this equation sin theta 2 equal to, we can write XE2 by JD2. Okay. So just what is the value of maximum voltage regulation? Just we try to write here. That means voltage regulation equal to maximum voltage regulation. Maximum voltage regulation equal to, just put the value of load power factor cos theta 2 and sin theta 2 in voltage regulation equation. Okay, so you may be right. In short, voltage regulation value, that means VR, equal to epsilon R. So what is the value of epsilon R? What is the value of epsilon, write down the value of epsilon R cos theta 2. So in place of cos theta 2, we can replace by this value. Yeah. That is RE2 by JD2. Right here. RE2 divided by JD2. RE2 plus epsilon x what is the value of sin theta 2? It means XE2 by JD2. Okay. XE2 by JD2. JD2. Okay. You may be right, the value of epsilon R, that means I2 RE2 divided by E2. So just replace this value, epsilon R equal to I2 RE2 divided by E2. So I2 RE2 RE2 divided by E2. RE2 divided by E2 into R E2 by Z E2. Okay. So into R E2 by Z E2. R E2 divided by Z E2. Plus epsilon x is equal to I2 x E2 divided by E2. So I2 x E2 divided by V2. Into X E2 by Z E2. X E2 by Z E2. X E2 divided by Z E2. So if you take common, that means I2 divided by P2 Z E2. So if you take common equation, or maybe right here, maximum voltage regulation. So maximum voltage regulation is equal to how much? From this equation, if we take the common of I2 divided by E2 into Z2, okay. So I2 divided by E2 into Z E2. So E2 into Z E2 then here in first term it means R E2 into R E2, that means R E2 square. So right here, R E2 square plus similarly X E2 into X E2, that means X E2 square, just X E2 square so this one we may be write as the Z E2 square, that means R E2 square plus X E2 square equal to how much? Z E2 square. So Z E2 square, we just write here for I2 divided by E2 into Z E2 Z E2 into here, how much? j t2 square. So z t2 square. Okay. So one j d2 from numerator and one j d2 from denominator cancel out. So remaining part is I2 j d2 divided by I2. So I2 j d2 divided by e2 divided by e2. So what is this one? We can decide the per unit impedance value equal to the secondary side. So this one we will write as the ZD2 in per unit. Okay. So ZE2 in per unit. Okay. In per unit. Okay. So you must be remember these two condition. One is your zero voltage regulation. Second one is your maximum voltage regulation. At which power factor we can get the zero voltage regulation, either lagging power factor or leading power factor. That means obvious tan theta equal to negative sign. So zero power factor, zero voltage regulation can be obtained at the leading power factor. At the load power factor is equal to how much? XE2 by ZE2. Okay. And what is the condition for maximum voltage regulation? That means at the power factor, load power factor equal to RE2 by ZE2. RE2 by ZE2. And what is the maximum voltage regulation value? That is equal to ZE2 in per unit. Okay. So ZE2 in per unit must be kept in your mind only. So we practice few times and solve some problem based on the voltage regulation, then you will be able to remember the voltage regulation condition at the different situation. Okay, either the zero voltage regulation and maximum voltage regulation, or what is the value of maximum voltage regulation. Okay, so this is all about voltage regulation of the transformer. We already discussed what are the factor affecting the voltage regulation. That means you may be say that the factor from the voltage regulation equation. Okay, so per unit equivalent resistance referred to the secondary side into cos theta 2, that is load power factor, plus per unit leakage reactance referred to the secondary side, this one, into sin theta 2. This one positive sign for the lagging power factor, and if you find out for the leading power factor, then this sign becomes negative. Other parameters are the same as it is usual for the lagging power factor. Okay, so no confusion in lagging and leading voltage regulation derivation or maybe equation. Okay. So epsilon r cos theta 2 plus epsilon x sin theta 2 is voltage regulation at the beginning. Leading power factor in per unit, if you multiply this one by 100, then you will get in percentage voltage regulation. Okay, so you may practice some problem based on the voltage regulation. Some problem even in the test book also various type of problem. So just go and practice this voltage regulation problem. Okay, so thank you. Just we stop here and. Next class, we will discuss some numerical based on this voltage regulation condition. Okay.
maybe stop here.